Hello, I'm David and in today's video I will show you few things before the Africa Twin rear shock rebuild. We will see how the shock is built, what parts we need for it, and how to improve it to make the oil change easier. First, let's look on overview of the shock absorber. We can see basic elements like spring, shock absorber body and remote gas tank. The tank stores gas under high pressure and there is around 15 bar or 220 psi. The main goal is to prevent cavitation, which forms gas bubbles while the oil flows through the piston. The second main component is the shock body. Let's look inside. In the body we have shock seal head, which keeps oil inside the shock absorber. There is also piston connected to the piston rod. The piston is guarded by two shim stacks, which regulate the damping force for the compression and rebound. Inside the gas tank we have just a bladder and two caps. To rebuild the shock we will need some new parts. Let's start with the oil seal. When it is damaged, the shock absorber is leaking oil. It is the most common problem with the rear shocks. Here you can see the new 3-piece oil seal, made of seal, O-ring and support plate. It is easy to set up. The original oil seal is made of 2 pieces, seal and support plate. The new oil seal is 30% thicker than original one. It is stronger and designed for up to 115 bars or 2175 psi. The next part we may want to change is the slide bushing. It guides the piston rod. Worn out slide bushing may damage piston rod coating, which may in turn destroy the oil seal very fast and lead to oil leakage again. On every sealing head removal, we should also change its O-ring. It is very easy to damage when we slide the sealing head out. Next important part is the dust seal. It keeps the sealing head clean inside, so the slide bushing and oil seal last longer. We were unable to find replacement for it, so we've made an adapter and used a normal simmering. This new seal has two lips. One normal and one with garter spring. The original dust seal has one lip with garter spring. You can also replace only the garter spring and leave the original seal as it's in good condition. The next part is piston rod. If there are any scratches or the coating is worn out, we should replace it. We've made a new piston rod with rubber bumper holder because it was extremely hard to remove. This rod is longer, so you can cut it like original or you can raise the bike up to 6 cm. We've made also new hose connecting reservoir to shock body. Now let's take a look at the gas tank. The original one has no gas valve at the cover, so it is impossible to service. We won't be able to pressurize the oil after the rebuild. One of the solutions for this is adding an air valve to the original cap. Of course, we also need a new O-ring to seal the original cap. The second solution is our new 2-in-1 gas tank cap. We can use it in two ways, like the original cap, or we can move the bladder to it, like it is in modern shock absorbers. In both cases we need a new O-ring, but luckily its size is the same. Let's compare how the oil change looks like in both solutions. First, we will see oil change procedure, where the bladder is in its original position. You can also skip to see the second approach. So, in the first method we start with pouring the oil into the bladder. Next we connect the bladder to the cap and shock body. And we add more oil. After that, we slowly insert the piston. We need to be careful, because if we will move the piston too fast, the bladder may fall off. Now we move piston up and down to get rid of air bubbles under the piston. We can also move the bladder and shock body around during that to make sure there is no air bubbles left. In the end, we put back the shock seal head. But there is a problem. You can notice big air bubble there, just under the shock seal head. Here we can see close up at the spot where the air bubble is built. To prevent it, we can drill a small vent like this. To make the vent, we need only a drill and a drill bit. Here you can see how I've made it in my old bike. After making the vent, we can install the seal head back. During this step, we lay down the shock a little, so that the vent will be the highest point of the shock. Thanks to this, air can escape from this area, so everything will be filled with oil. With this position, we press in the cylinder a little to push out some oil and air through this vent. Finally, we can press in the seal head and secure it with retaining ring. Be careful, because the bladder may fall off when you press the seal head too much and oil pressure will be too big. Next, we pull back the seal head and lock it in place. After that, we push in the rod all the way in. During that, we must squeeze the bladder around to pour out the oil. We must squeeze the bladder like in the picture, because without squeezing the bladder will fall off and we would have to start from the beginning. Now we install air can body and its cap. And we are done. The only thing left is pumping gas into the can. This whole method works with the original air can cap as well with our new cap. Now let's check out the second method. This time we start with the shock body connected to the air can. First, we slide in the piston into the shock absorber body. Next, we install the sealing head and lock it using retaining ring. Now we pour in the oil through the air can. There will be a lot of air inside, so we need to pump the shock and keep adding more oil. Before next step, we pull the piston rod almost all the way out. Now in the last step, we insert the bladder with new cap. The piston rod should slide out completely during this step or after pumping gas into the bladder. And that's it. So in summary, the original shock was not designed for service. There is no air valve in air can to pump the gas and the bladder is placed in wrong way. We can solve this with two methods. We can add an air valve to the air can cover and drill a hole in the seal head to vent the air under it, or we can just move the bladder to the second side of the air can and make the oil change much easier. The choice is up to you. In upcoming video about Africa Twin Shock, we will put it together using the second method and see how easy it is in real life. In meantime, we are preparing some parts for montage. Now let's see how to add the air valve to the original air can cap. You need to drill a hole in the center of the original cap. There isn't much space inside, so you have to be precise. To get rid of sharp edges, we can use big drill bit. After that, we can smooth it with abrasive fabric. Next, we degrease it with brake cleaner. Then we can insert a valve and secure it with a nut and strong thread locking fluid. For double security, we can add some silicone or epoxy inside. In my case, I used some silicone. I try to not leave any empty space. At the end, I additionally press the silicone in and smooth it using my finger. To clean the cap, I use some cloth. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video about Africa Twin Rear Shock.